So the other night, I thought I saw the face of God in a dream. Hard to describe something like an out-of-body experience, but on my astral travels, I encountered many sentient beings like ghosts, spirits, demons, and angels flapping wings. Now, I'm usually hard, but fuck that, I was scared. So playing a funeral dirge to fear, my star guide calls me to come near, that I may finally quiet the poltergeist in my mind and establish new frontiers of elemental tranquility sung by nature's nature beings. I immersed myself in divine light and became pure of potential energy while discovering that Jesus betrayed by Judas was really Joshua in a past life. And philosophy at its finest, about the lost city of Atlantis, transcending time in a trance through transcendental meditative mantras. I was wooed by the prowess of Aya, the Yoruba goddess, and hurt by the pain of Atlas. I drank wine from Mount Olympus, taken directly from the lips of Bacchus. I danced with the snake charmers in the Indus River Valley as they proceeded to regale me with the epic of Gilgamesh, while summoning from the Asper, tasting Cleopatra's flesh. Yes, the universe is a dreamer, a cold conspirative schemer, and helping every human creature fulfill its wildest dreams. God asked, my son, how could you forget that you are a star? You have an all, what more do you need to blow up? Like a supernova, you are a masterpiece of a creature. So the world should be your oyster. For the human mind loses nothing, it just forgets it all in the ether. Man was a feast on something resplendent, like Picasso, Mozart, Neruda, like nebulous forming stars, keyword scars, electric guitars, like the seasoning sorrow of battle, or Michelangelo's Sistine Chapel, like Da Vinci's eerie heart, conversing with Galileo's soul. I thought God was too much to bear, like a blazing, bittersweet bloodshot of beating drunk on rising. While Africa tings fireworks of genius, ignite remnants of wildest dreams. Shit, I thought I was hallucinating. Like ingesting large amounts of sabia divinorum, LSD, cannabis, and peyote leaves all mixed with the bark of a tree. Like the other night, I thought I saw the face of God in a dream, and his light set my soul spinning as my brain wrecked serotonin's curtain call while bopping to melatonin's beat. Like the five classical elements influencing the various stages of sleep. When I was younger, I used to think that ignorance makes unconsciousness sweet. But while having this particular dream, I never felt so alive. I don't know God. I'm just here to preach the non-existence of darkness. You see, Socrates used to say, there is one good in the world, knowledge, and only one evil, ignorance. Therefore, it is knowledgeable to say that darkness is the absence of light, but ignorant to proclaim that light is the absence of darkness, because darkness is a mirage. Therefore, ignorance is a mirage. Therefore, evil is a mirage. So you see, my dreams have taught me to live my life without fear, because the moment we wake up, hatred will invariably disappear. The other night, I thought I saw the face of God in a dream, and her light set my soul spinning. God is light, and since the beginning, fight to return back from whence you came. So I made love in the heavens the other night, and shit was hot. And as God pressed the omniscient palm to my breast, I pledged an oath of allegiance to the stars before I awoke, drenched, flooded, and bathed in a cold.